So, in the last class, I told you the meaning of NPA, the classification of NPA. Then we discussed the prompt corrective action framework, right? For the cooperative banks, we discussed supervisory action framework. And we also discussed the prudential norms. For resolution of the stressed assets, right? After that, we discussed intercreditor agreement also. So all these things we discussed in the last class about the NPA. So if you want to see these things, I will upload the YouTube recording on the YouTube very, very soon. The PPT I have already uploaded on the Telegram group yesterday. So yesterday night I uploaded all the PowerPoint presentations. You can see and you can revise from there also. Okay. Sir, can you please upload the index PPT on the Telegram group? Yes, it is already there. Already humne already upload ki bhi hai. Theek hai. Chaliye. Now, let us quickly see different tools of recovering the NPAs, right? So we let us see quickly the different tools of recovering the NPA. So in these tools, you should have a basic idea what is the purpose. And if something is in use in the recent time, then I will tell you what is in news, and accordingly, we will discuss that particular important aspect. So there are various tools to recover the NPA. है ना, हम बात कर रहे हैं एनपीए रिकवर करने का. प्लीज टेक केयर, इट इज अबाउट द रिकवरी. रिकवरी मींस द बैंक इज ट्राइंग टू रिकवर फ्रॉम द डिफॉल्टर, फ्रॉम द बोरोवर. इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट स्ट्रेटजी. इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम, बेसिकली इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट स्ट्रेटजी. इट इज जस्ट वन पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट स्ट्रेटजी. इफ यू सी फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, द गवर्नमेंट हैज 4 R स्ट्रेटजी, राइट? गवर्नमेंट के पास में 4 R स्ट्रेटजी है, विच टॉक्स अबाउट रिकॉग्निशन, रिजोल्यूशन, रिकैपिटलाइजेशन एंड रिफॉर्म्स. रिकॉग्निशन मींस दैट ऑल द लोन्स एंड एडवांसेस should be properly recognized as NPA, right? So they should not be under recognition. So the rules and guidelines have been clearly framed so that there is no under recognition. Resolution basically means taking the appropriate steps in the direction of recovery, in the direction of recovery, right? So all these are basically part of the resolution. Apart from that, we also have this insolvency and bankruptcy code, which is a very, very powerful initiative. Yesterday we discussed that as per the economic survey, this insolvency and bankruptcy code has proved to be the topmost recovery channel, means highest amount of NPAs have been recovered from the IBC channel. Insolvency and bankruptcy code से. Then we have recapitalization. What is recapitalization? So because of high NPAs, the capital of banks have been reduced. Because when there is NPA, banks are supposed to make the provision. What is the meaning of provision? Provision is basically keeping apart a percentage of loan out of the profits of the bank. तो जो बैंक के प्रॉफिट है उसमें से हम लोन का कुछ परसेंटेज के बराबर अमाउंट हम साइड में रख देते हैं. वी कीप इट एज ए रिजर्व सो दैट इन द फ्यूचर इफ द लोन इज नॉट रिकवर्ड, वी कैन एडजस्ट दैट अमाउंट अगेंस्ट दैट एंड वी डू नॉट फेस द सडन शॉक. तो फ्यूचर में सडन शॉक से बचने के लिए हम लोग रिजर्व क्रिएट कर देते हैं. बिकॉज ऑफ दीज रिजर्व्स, बिकॉज ऑफ दीज रिजर्व्स, द प्रॉफिट्स ऑफ द बैंक हैव बीन रिड्यूसिंग एंड द बैंक्स नीड सम कैपिटल. In India, the government is the primary owner of the public sector banks. So government has been recapitalizing the public sector banks, and the total recapitalization package is 2.1 lakh crore. Apart from that, there are other various reforms undertaken in the form of Mission Indradhanush, where we are talking about the governance reforms and various other reforms. These reforms we will discuss separately as part of the banking reforms. So this 4R strategy is the overall strategy of the government. Ye government ki overall strategy hai. Out of this, these are the steps for recovering the NPA. Ye NPA recover karne ke steps hai. We should know only the purpose of each of these initiatives. Hame sirf purpose pata hona chahiye. We are not supposed to get into much detail of these initiatives. So the first two, that is the compromise settlement scheme and Lok Adalats, these are the mediation schemes where arbitration, conciliation, all these mechanisms are used. Alternate dispute settlement mechanism is used, right? So this is basically kind of alternative disputes resolution mechanism where some kind of mediator might be used, right? Some kind of mediator between the bank and the defaulter can be used, who will sit between the two and will try to resolve this NPA in the amicable manner, right? This Lok Adalat is a very general term you will find in the polity. Lok Adalat, if we see this concept, was first advocated by Justice P.N. Bhagwati, who was the former Chief Justice of India. This is based upon the principles of Panch Parameshwar of the Gram Panchayat, right? So, jo mediator hota hai, hum usko Panch Parameshwar mante hain. Jo usne bataya, hum usko mante hain. So, the second one is the Lok Adalat. The first one is also kind of this mechanism only, where there is a compromise settlement. The bank agrees that, okay, because in some cases the situation of borrower can be very, very poor. So in those cases, the bank is ready to forego some interest. The bank is ready to forego some interest, right? So that is called compromise settlement scheme. The third one is corporate debt structuring. So if you just decodify this word, corporate means company. Company which is registered under the Companies Act. Debt means loan. Restructuring means we are basically relaxing the terms and conditions right. So this relaxation of terms and conditions can be in various forms. It can be either in the form of waiver of some interest. So for example, waiving of 6 month interest, 1 year interest, some concession in the payment, converting the unserviced portion of interest into the term loan. That is, if some interest is payable, we will convert that into the term loan. That means interest can be paid in the installment. Refacement of recovery schedule. That means we will change the recovery schedule. Suppose it was for 10 years originally, so we will convert it into 25 years, like that. Reduction in margin. Again, that means the bank will reduce the rate of interest. Reassessment of credit facilities. So under this, the bank might recover some amount of NPA from the borrower and would like to continue another part of the loan, because if that loan is continued, there is a chance that borrower can recover from the crisis. Okay. So this is reassessment of credit facilities. The next mechanism is debt recovery tribunal. So under this, what is important is that this debt recovery tribunal is set up under Recovery of Debts Due to Banks and Financial Institutions Act 1993, right? So there is a separate law, there is a separate legislature under which this tribunal is working and central government is empowered to establish the debt recovery tribunal. If someone is not satisfied with the decision of the DRT, debt recovery tribunal, then they can go to the debt recovery appellate tribunal and they can file their case. So the appeals against the order of DRT, they can be filed with the debt recovery appellate tribunal. Right. So basically the purpose of debt recovery tribunal is to support, to facilitate the debt recovery for the banks and the financial institutions. This mechanism has been in news very recently. After this direct tax Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, under this scheme, this DRT has been used as one of the tool to resolve the issues, right? That is why this DRT has been in news. And you should understand only two important things, that this is under a law and central government setups this kind of tribunal, right? So it is not the judiciary, it is not the Supreme Court, it is not the High Court, rather it is the central government. Please keep in mind, it is the central government which set up the DRT. What are the powers and functions? So it acts, it enforces the provisions of two acts. One is recovery of debts to the bank and financial institutions. And second, there is another act, very, very powerful act, SARFAESI Act. So under the SARFAESI Act also, the case can be filed by the banks with the DRT. So DRT ke saath, DRT ke paas mein ye case file kiya ja sakta hai. This ensures the fast recovery of loan, because if the bank go to the general courts, normal courts, district court, high court, supreme court, in that case, it might take a lot of time, years, and the probability of NPA getting recovered can be reduced. So these debt recovery tribunals, they have been set up for a specific purpose of recovering the loan in the fast forward manner, right? So the purpose is basically to fast forward the recovery of the NPAs. Then we have SARFAESI Act. So let us decodify this act. Let us see what happens under this act. Is act ke andar kya hota hai? So here if we see the term securitization of financial assets, what is the meaning of the word securitization? We will discuss in the next slide. Hum isko aaram se discuss karenge, acche se sab discuss karenge, because this term is in news very frequently. So you should understand what is the meaning of securitization. So basically, under the SARFAESI Act, the bank can avail the services of the securitization. It can convert its loan amounts into the security receipt, and it can sell those security receipt to some agency, and that agency can pay some amount to the bank in response to return of these securities, right? So this securitization is allowed. We will discuss more about securitization. As of now, just understand ki securitization mein kya hota hai. Bank apne loan ko security mein convert kar deta hai. Jo bhi usne loan diye apne customers ko, usko security mein convert kar deta hai aur usko sell kar deta hai. To bank bolta hai ki ye jo loan recover hone hai mere customer se, ye loan aap recover kar lijiye, main recover nahi karunga, aur uske badle mein mujhe kuch paisa de dijiye. So you can recover the loan and you can give me less money in return. Aap mujhe kam paisa de dijiye, aap mere customer se zyada paisa recover kar lijiye. Suppose unka due tha 100 rupees, aap usse 100 rupees recover kar lijiye aur mujhe 95 rupees de dijiye, 5 rupees aapka benefit ho gaya. Theek hai? So this is the kind of exercise which is done in the securitization. It also ensures reconstruction of financial assets. That means basically when some borrower is taking the loan, borrower keeps some kind of security with the bank. Bank ke paas kuch na kuch security rakhta hai. When the security is kept, this can be used to recover the loan in case of default. So the management of such security, how such security will be managed. Suppose koi house property girvi rakh di, some house is kept as pledge, how to manage the sale of the house? Who will be the owner of the house? At what price this house will be sold, right? How the house will be vacated? All these things are discussed, are elaborated, are provided under the reconstruction of financial assets. So management of sale of debt, restructuring also, settlement also, taking possession, all these things, they are done as part of the reconstruction of financial assets. Then enforcing the security interest by the security creditor without intervention of the court. This is very, very important. Without the intervention of the court, yani ke koi bhi court intervene nahin kar sakta. This is very, very important. If you have placed some security with the bank and you are not repaying the loan, bank can directly sell your property after giving you some notice. If you go to the high court, they will not give a stay notice to the bank. So there is no intervention allowed in case of Sarfaezi Act. Okay. It acts as the agent of banks, FBIs for recovery agent and all those things. So this is a very, very powerful tool for the recovery of loans. Now, what is the meaning of securitization? Let us discuss this. This is very, very important. You will find this term frequently, very, very frequently in the newspapers. Aapko newspaper mein dekhne ko bahut milega ye. Theek hai? So any doubt so far by anyone? Please ask your doubt if you have any doubt, or just say no if you don't have any doubt, so that I can understand that you are getting everything. So this is the process of securitization, right? So you can see again, banks or financial institution will collect the money into a pool. This money is basically loan assets, the loan diye hue hain, theek hai? This division of pool will be done into small parts, and those parts will be sold as a security. So here the third party help will be taken, right? Then the buyers of the security, they get the interest, and these securities are called mortgage backed securities. Securitization refers to the process of converting debt, that is the assets, into the securities, which are then bought and sold in the financial market. Rahul is asking, individual investor cannot directly buy security from the market. Normally, bank do not sell to the individual investor. Normally, this work is done with the help of third parties. Okay? So third party hoti hai, jisko hum bolte hai, asset reconstruction company. Jo third party jo hoti hai, ye, special purpose vehicle jo hoti hai, isko bolte hai, ARC, asset reconstruction companies. Normally, wahi ye sab kaam karti hai. Banks are not involving themselves into these activities. Okay? They are the specialist agency. That is why bank take help of those agencies. So you can see, securitization is the process of pooling and repackaging of financial assets. So jo humne loan diye the, the loan which were given by the State Bank of India, they have been pooled and repackaged into marketable securities, and then can be sold to the investors. In other words, it basically involves repackaging of less liquid. Less liquid kyun hai? Why we are calling it less liquid? Because they can be recovered only in 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. So these are the term loans. Ye term loan hai jo customer se immediately recover nahi kiya ja sakte. Less liquid hai. We are not saying less viable. Less liquid does not mean they cannot be recovered. They can be recovered, but after some time. Into the saleable securities, that means more liquid securities. So this is the process of securitization. Now, why I discussed this process? Maine ye process kyun discuss kiya? Rahul, can you ask the doubt whenever I ask you to ask the doubt? When I am discussing something, please don't ask the doubt in between. Okay? that disturbs my attention. I give you sufficient time to ask the doubt. तब पूछा करो, ठीक है? Because why I'm saying that, there are two reasons. First of all, when I am discussing something, you are not able to understand that thing. If you are busy typing in your chat box, ठीक है ना? आपको वो चीज समझ में नहीं आएगी. Second thing, my attention is also diverted to your query. So I give you sufficient time to ask the query. Please ask the query at that time only. Thank you very much for the cooperation. Now, partial credit guarantee scheme. So please understand this. This is the name of the scheme, partial credit guarantee scheme, which has been offered by the government of India to the public sector banks. This scheme was announced in the July 2019 budget. And in this scheme, the public sector banks, they can buy high rated pooled assets from the NBFCs, financial sound NBFCs or housing financing companies, right? So aapko pata hoga, NBFC sector is in crisis. There is a very big liquidity problem which arose in the NBFC sector, especially after the IL&FS crisis. IL&FS crisis ke baad mein kaafi samasya ho gayi thi, theek hai? Then we had DHFL, all these things. Because of all these things, the NBFC sector came into crisis, and the government introduced this scheme. Under this scheme, the government is saying that any public sector bank, for example, Punjab National Bank can buy the loan papers of any NBFC. NBFC ke loan paper ko buy kar sakta hai. And what is the meaning of loan paper? Basically, it means, jo maine aapko example diya tha securitization mein, ki securitization mein NBFC ne jo loan diye honge further, the loans which would have been given by the NBFC, the NBFC will convert these loan into the security paper. So those security paper are called the loan paper. Usko hum kya bolte hain? Loan paper bolte hain. Theek hai? To jo ye loan paper hain, these loan papers can be purchased by the public sector banks so that the liquidity can be given to the NBFC. So that NBFC get the fund. So the liquidity crisis in the NBFC sector can be managed. And this is the partial credit guarantee. Some guarantee is being given by the central government. That means in case these loan papers become NPA, the NBFC's loan, they are not recoverable, but they have been purchased by the Punjab National Bank, then central government will be compensating to the PNB, because central government has given the guarantee for purchase of these securities. So central government ne guarantee di hai aise securities ko buy karne ke liye. Are you getting, my friends? So this is partial credit guarantee scheme. Isko hum bolte hain partial credit guarantee scheme, right? So under the above scheme, public sector bank can purchase the loan paper of NBFC only through direct assignment and not through securitization to provide liquidity to the NBFC and manage their asset liability mismatch issue. ठीक है? So here they will not, go into some third party. वो third party की help नहीं लेंगे. So it will not be a purely securitization process. It will not be a purely securitization process. It will be direct assignment. That means the PNB will directly buy the loan of the NBFC. वो directly loan को buy कर लेगी. It will recover the loan directly. So central government will provide the partial credit guarantee on these assets. That is, if in the future these loan papers are turned into the NPA, then government of India will pay to the Punjab National Bank, right? But there is a restriction. Ek restriction hai that only high rated loans up to 1 lakh crore rupees till February 2020 can be purchased. Only and only high rated loans are allowed under this scheme. ठीक है? So you can see here, the time of a scheme is 6 months from the announcement, that is till February 2020 or till 1 lakh crore, whichever is earlier. Guarantee kitni hogi? So we said it is the partial guarantee. So how much is the guarantee? First loss of up to 10% of the amount, and this guarantee is valid up to 24 month. ठीक है, तो गारंटी कितनी है? 10% तक की गारंटी है बस. हाउ इट विल हेल्प? इट विल प्रोवाइड द लिक्विडिटी टू द एनबीएफसी हु आर फेसिंग टेम्परेरी एसेट लायबिलिटी मिसमैच, दैट इज द लिक्विडिटी प्रॉब्लम. लायबिलिटी ज्यादा है, एसेट कम है, तो दिस इज द लिक्विडिटी प्रॉब्लम. सो इट विल हेल्प अवॉइड द डिस्ट्रेस सेल ऑफ द एसेट. उनको अपनी जो एसेट है वो मजबूरी में सेल नहीं करनी होगी. ठीक है, there are some guidelines that only rated assets can be acquired and this acquisition will be done at the fair value. Fair value kya hota hai? Fair value means the market price, right? So the real worth of the loan will be checked. Agar koi loan NPA ban gaya hai to uske liye paisa nahi dega bank. That is why this is called fair value, right? This is not the book value. Book value kya hoti hai? Ki jitne rupaye ka loan diya tha utna hi bank pay kar raha hai NBFC को. नो, इन दैट केस वी आर सेइंग दिस इज द मार्केट वैल्यू, फेयर वैल्यू. आज के समय में उस लोन की कितनी वैल्यू है? अगर कोई एनपीए बन गया है तो उसको हम हटा देंगे, उसकी वैल्यू जीरो लेंगे. एनबीएफसी कैन बाय बैक दिस लोन पेपर विद इन 12 मंथ, आफ्टर 12 मंथ. हु कैन टेक दिस स्कीम एडवांटेज? आरबीआई रजिस्टर्ड एनबीएफसी, एनएचबी रजिस्टर्ड एचएफसी प्लस कैपिटल, NPS profitability, कुछ कैपिटल उनके लिए होनी चाहिए, NPA की कुछ कंडीशन होती हैं और कुछ प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी कंडीशन होती है. दीज आर द थ्री कंडीशंस व्हिच आर सपोज टू बी मेट बाय देम. ठीक है, यानी कि ये PCA वाली कंडीशंस होंगी. प्रॉम्प्ट करेक्टिव एक्शन फ्रेमवर्क आपको याद है? डू यू रिमेंबर दिस प्रॉम्प्ट करेक्टिव एक्शन फ्रेमवर्क? सो अंडर द प्रॉम्प्ट करेक्टिव एक्शन फ्रेमवर्क देर आर थ्री कंडीशंस, राइट? So if these three conditions are breached, अगर वहां पर कुछ लिमिट क्रॉस हो जाती है तो हम PCA में डाल देते हैं. सिमिलरली हियर ऑल्सो दीज लिमिट शुड नॉट बी क्रॉस्ड. ये लिमिट क्रॉस नहीं होनी चाहिए. द कंडीशन ऑफ कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो, द कंडीशन ऑफ NPA एंड द कंडीशन ऑफ रिटर्न ऑन इक्विटी. ठीक है, तो कैपिटल, NPA एंड प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी कंडीशन, दीज थ्री कंडीशन शुड नॉट बी ब्रीच्ड. दैट मीन्स सच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड नॉट बी अनवायबल. Now, apart from that, we have steps taken against the willful defaulters. ठीक है, तो हम लोगों ने डिस्कस किया बहुत सारे मैकेनिज्म, जिसमें से एक मैकेनिज्म willful defaulters को भी अटैक करने का है. What is the meaning of willful defaulter? A borrower who defaults on the loan repayment to the bank despite having the capacity to pay. तो मेन इंपॉर्टेंट क्या है कि उसके पास कैपेसिटी टू पे है. The person has the capacity to pay. The person has siphoned off the funds. Has disposed of the property which were given as a security. जिस प्रॉपर्टी को सिक्योरिटी की तरह दिया गया था वो प्रॉपर्टी को सेल कर दिया. अब बैंक के पास में कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है. ठीक है, बैंक डू नॉट हैव एनी ऑप्शन. द गवर्नमेंट हैज प्लान्ड सर्टेन थिंग्स, स्पेशल ट्राइब्यूनल फॉर द हाई वैल्यू केसेस, स्पेशल कोर्ट्स सो दैट दे कैन फेस द क्रिमिनल चार्जेस, सम काइंड ऑफ जेल टर्म, एंड बैंक कैन ऑल्सो सी द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ बोर्ड अंडर न्यू लॉ. ठीक है, तो कंपनी जो बोर्ड है उसका डिसोल्यूशन भी किया जा सकता है. फ्यूजिटिव इकोनॉमिक ऑफेंडर, राइट? सो प्लीज आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन, देन वी विल डिस्कस दिस. गिव द आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स. Please keep giving the answer. I want the answer from everyone. Even if you don't know, you should try. Okay, good. So queries, I got two queries. Saitya, your queries, sir, subprime crisis of USA 2008 is mostly due to toxic securities. Yes, it is very correct. Bilkul sahi baat hai. So basically what happened at that time, the loan which were given by the banks in the USA to the housing for the housing purpose, that is a home loan, those loans, they turned bad, and because of that, those people who purchased the securities of such loans, they also get into trouble. So that there was a boom of housing sector. That boom was bust after 2008 crisis. Rahul is saying, sir, recently Supreme Court told that SARFAESI is to be extended to the cooperative banks. So basically, there have been controversies around the application of SARFAESI Act to the cooperative banks. Cooperative bank par applicable hoga ya nahi hoga, uske bare mein bahut samay se controversy rahi hai. So recently, last week only, the Supreme Court gave its judgment in one of the case, in the case of PMC basically. Theek hai? So Supreme Court said that even the cooperative banks are eligible to get the advantage of the SARFAESI Act. So the SARFAESI Act, there is a section number 2 who defines which agencies are eligible to get the advantage of the SARFAESI Act. So what is the benefit of the SARFAESI Act? The benefit of SARFAESI Act is that if the borrower do not pay the amount within 60 days, then bank can take the appropriate steps. Bank can recover the loan by selling the security. So this is a big advantage. The court cannot intervene. Court intervene nahin kar sakta. Puri power hoti hai bank ke paas ki wo us property ko sell karke aur apna loan recover kar le. This is a very, very big power. The controversy was have been going on that this is not applicable on the cooperative bank. Finally, Supreme Court told that this is applicable on the cooperative bank also. So cooperative bank can also take the advantage, right? This is a decision of the Supreme Court. Yes, Supreme Court ka decision hai. And the decision of the Supreme Court, the decision of the Supreme Court becomes the law of the land. Usko law of the land ban jata hai wo. It means that is applicable on all the agencies. Sir, what is the difference between the act and the code, right? So act basically होता है कि कोई भी जो बिल पार्लियामेंट में कोई बिल पास होता है उसको हम एक्ट बोलते हैं, ठीक है? जो बिल पार्लियामेंट में पास होता है, लेजिस्लेचर उसको पास करता है, उसको हम बोलते हैं एक्ट, ठीक है? कोड, कोड कोई टेक्निकल टर्म नहीं है, इट इज नॉट ए टेक्निकल टर्म, इट इज नॉट ए लेजिस्लेटिव टर्म, कोई लेजिस्लेटिव टर्म नहीं है, बट दिस हैज बीन यूज्ड इन द इंसॉल्वेंसी एंड बैंकरप्सी कोड. इसको इंसॉल्वेंसी एंड बैंकरप्सी कोड में यूज किया गया है. बट दिस इज नॉट ए टेक्निकल टर्म, कोई टेक्निकल टर्म नहीं है ये, ठीक है? एक्ट इज ए टेक्निकल टर्म, एक्ट इज ए टेक्निकल टर्म. सो प्रोबेबली द डिफरेंस कैन बी कोड डज नॉट रिप्रेजेंट द अप्रूवल ऑफ द लॉ, वो लॉ की अप्रूवल रिप्रेजेंट नहीं करता, ठीक है? इट इज गिवन बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, बट आई एम नॉट श्योर, दिस इज द मोस्ट प्रोबेबल आंसर. द कोड इज गिवन बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड द एक्ट इज पास्ड बाय द लेजिस्लेचर, ठीक है? एक्ट बाय द लेजिस्लेचर एंड कोड बाय द एग्जीक्यूटिव, ठीक है? शुभाजीत, सर आई एम कंफ्यूज बिटवीन 100 crore एंड 50 crore. डोंट वरी, we will discuss it. अभी हम इसी को डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं, ठीक है? चलिए. सो फ्यूजिटिव इकोनॉमिक ऑफेंडर, तो बहुत सारे लोग पैसा लेके भाग गए, है ना? मैनी ऑफ देम, मैनी ऑफ द विलफुल डिफॉल्टर्स, दे फ्लेड अवे फ्रॉम द इंडिया. आपको ऑलरेडी पता है नीरव मोदी, विजय माल्या. सो एन एक्ट वॉज पास्ड इन द 2018. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ fugitive economic offender? You should know about this. A person can be named as offender under this law if arrest warrant has been issued against him. Very very important. पहली जो condition है वो क्या है? Arrest warrant issued किया गया हो. The amount should be rupees 100 crore or more. And he has fled from India for escaping the legal action. ठीक है? तो वो इंडिया को छोड़ दिया हो उसने. For escaping the legal action, these are the three condition for calling any person as the fugitive economic offender. So you should understand these three terms very very clearly, because in the prelims examination they can ask these three terms by giving the separate statement. बिल्कुल वो पूछ सकते हैं. Nowadays they are asking couple of questions from the economic laws. For example, money laundering, है ना? इस तरह के लॉ से वो questions पूछ रहे हैं. So there is no surprise, the question can come from the fugitive economic offender bill also. Okay. Now this is the legal definition. Ye legal definition hai. Section 2 mein, there should be a scheduled offense. The offenses are well defined. He has left India and he refuses to return to India. वो इंडिया में आने से मना कर देता है, जैसे कि विजय माल्या हो गया, नीरव मोदी हो गया, है ना? यस्टरडे देयर वाज अ न्यूज़ अबाउट नीरव मोदी, सो एलिगेशंस बाय द बीजेपी, राइट? 100 crore और मोर, राइट? द मेन थिंग यू कैन सी इज such offenders will be criminals, not the civil you know violators. unko crime ki category mein rakha gaya hai. They have done the crime, right? Willful default, cheating, forgery, they are deemed as the economic offenses. So jab hum baat karte hain scheduled offense ki here, so willful default, forgery, cheating, these are part of the scheduled offense. It also allows the government, so here the government has big power to impound, seize and seal the assets, including the benami assets. Benami asset means those assets which are not registered in the name of the defaulter, but they belong to the defaulter. Wo uske naam pe nahi hai lekin wo usi se belong karti hai, ya to usne apne रिलेटिव के नाम पे उसको रजिस्टर करा के रखा हुआ है, अपने सर्वेंट के नाम पे रजिस्टर करा के रखा हुआ है, somehow that person has not registered in his name to escape the sale of these assets by the bank in case of default, right? So the right to seize, seal, all these rights have been given until they surrender under the jurisdiction of India. जब तक कि वो इंडिया के अंदर सरेंडर ना करे. There are some procedures given in the Act. The investigating agency, so primarily the investigating agency is Enforcement Directorate, right? Enforcement Directorate will file an application to the Special Court under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, telling the details about the properties which needs to be confiscated and any information about the whereabouts. ठीक है, तो Enforcement Directorate is the responsible agency. Even we are using the Prevention of Money Laundering Act under here. एक नोटिस मिलेगा 6 वीक का, राइट? इफ द पर्सन अपीयर्स इन अगेंस्ट द नोटिस देन प्रोसीडिंग्स विल बी टर्मिनेटेड. अगर पर्सन अपीयर नहीं होता है द पर्सन विल बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज द फ्यूजिटिव इकोनॉमिक ऑफेंडर. द फ्यूजिटिव इकोनॉमिक ऑफेंडर कैन चैलेंज हिज नेम being called as the FEO in the High Court within 30 days of declaration as the FEO. There are many other government steps which are being taken by the government to take care of FEO. ठीक है, तो ये steps government ले रही है to avoid the person from fleeing out of India and to actually take like a kind of scrutiny, kind of vigil. The government has issued instruction that all accounts exceeding 50 crore, if classified as NPA, be examined by the banks from the angle of possible fraud. ठीक है, it means अगर 50 crore का NPA हो गया है, such NPA should be examined whether there is a fraud. कोई fraud तो नहीं हुआ है, ठीक है? In addition, public sector bank have also been advised to seek a report on the borrower from the सेंट्रल इकोनॉमिक इंटेलिजेंस ब्यूरो. तो उनके बारे में कोई इंटेलिजेंस अगर मिल सकती है तो अच्छा रहेगा. प्रोएक्टिव एक्शन विल बी टेकन. इवन वन अथॉरिटी हैज बीन सेटअप फॉर एनफोर्समेंट ऑफ ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स एंड एंश्योरिंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ ऑडिट्स. तो ऑडिट के लिए एक एजेंसी बनाई गई है जिसको बोलते हैं नेशनल फाइनेंशियल रिपोर्टिंग अथॉरिटी. सो द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट ऑफ दीज एनपीए होल्डर्स दे विल बी एग्जामिन्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज स्टैंडर्ड्स. With the help of these standards which are set by the NFRA, right? Pursuant to government's advice to PSBs, the public sector banks have been obtaining the certified copy of the passport of promoter or director and other authorized signatory of availing the loan facilities of more than 50 crore and are ensuring rotational transfer of officials employees on the sensitive post. So, under this step, all the loan of more than 50 crore rupees, if anyone takes the loan of more than 51 crore rupees, the government takes these banks take the certified copy of passport of the promoter and director, right? So that in case this loan turned into NPA, the intelligence agency can be informed and they can be ensured that they do not fled away from the India. ठीक है? So now answer to the question of किसने question पूछा था? Shubhajit, my friend, fugitive economic offender, in case of fugitive economic offender, the person is declared as the fugitive economic offender only when the loan is more than 100 crore rupees. Jab loan 100 crore rupees se jyada ka hoga, theek hai? And the government is taking the proactive step that if the loan is more than 50 crore rupees, then only we will take the passport copy as a proactive measure. ठीक है, so Manish, don't worry, have trust. 100 crore rupees act के अंदर दिया गया है. Please understand, all these, this particular slide, this is not part of the fugitive economic offender bill. Please understand what I'm saying. That is why I say, don't try to use your own intelligence during the lectures. अगर आप खुद का दिमाग use करोगे then you will not listen, right? And you will be एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन यू विल बी कंफ्यूज्ड, आप सेशन के एंड पे कंफ्यूज हो जाओगे कि सर क्या बता रहे हैं, मैं क्या देख रहा हूँ, इंटरनेट क्या बोल रहा है, मेरे पे ट्रस्ट कर लो यार। अब यहाँ पे आए हो तो ट्रस्ट तो करते हो ना मेरे पे, तो इसमें भी कर लो थोड़ा ट्रस्ट। व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज इन द फ्यूजिटिव इकोनॉमिक ऑफेंडर बिल द लिमिट इज 100 करोड़ ओनली, बट द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग मैनी स्टेप्स इवन बिफोर द पर्सन बिकम्स FEO. So as a proactive step, the government has advised the banks that if you are giving the loan of more than 50 crore rupees, then please take a certified copy of passport from them. And if they turn into NPA, give the information to the intelligence agencies. They will ensure that person do not fled away from India. ठीक है? तो government तो आगे चल रही है ना? Are you getting? So Shubhajit, did you get the answer to your query? 100 crore, 50 crore? 100 crore is the limit given in the law. 50 crore is a proactive step, which is different from the law. Okay? So don't confuse yourself. Don't do unnecessary research on the internet. Internet pe toh bahut kuch hai. Confuse ho jaoge. Okay? So answer to this question is option A. Statement 1 is correct. Statement 2 is not correct because the steps are being taken for 50 crore only. ठीक है? During the COVID-19, certain relaxations have been given for the NPA, है ना? So there have been 3 months moratorium. That means if the person is not paying within 90 days, then the person will not be declared as the NPA. ठीक है? Now, some other concepts I want to tell you. Please give the answer to this question. Please give the answer in the chat box privately. Privately answer though. Supriya, where is your answer? Manish, aapka answer kahan hai? Everyone please participate. Divya, Rahul. Okay, Rahul ne de diya hai. Theek hai. Surajit, आपका आंसर नहीं मिला. Surajit, योर आंसर. Venkatesh, Give the answer. Don't worry about the accuracy. Give the answer. Chaliye, very good. So the answer to this question is option C, one only. Right? Statement one is correct. In the statement two, it is the unconventional policy tool adopted by central bank. ठीक है, तो कॉमन सेंस है. कोई भी अगर इंटरेस्ट रेट की बात करते हैं तो कोई भी इंटरेस्ट रेट सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट को डिटरमिन करती नहीं है. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट नेवर प्लेस डायरेक्ट इंटरवेंशन इन द इंटरेस्ट रेट. इट इज अ सेंट्रल बैंक, राइट? सो स्टेटमेंट टू इज इनकरेक्ट. इफ यू नो दैट स्टेटमेंट टू इज इनकरेक्ट, वेरी वेरी इजिली यू कैन एलिमिनेट ऑल द थ्री ऑप्शंस. है ना, आप आराम से तीनों ऑप्शंस को एलिमिनेट कर सकते हो. दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, बट मोस्ट ऑफ यू हैव गिवन द रॉन्ग आंसर. आप मैक्सिमम लोगों ने रॉन्ग आंसर दिया है, ठीक है ना? सो प्लीज टेक केयर ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी वेरी इजी. ये बहुत ही इजी क्वेश्चंस की कैटेगरी में आता है ना? कोई बात नहीं, यू आर हियर फॉर लर्निंग. सो नॉर्मली नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस टर्म नेगेटिव रेट पॉलिसी. सो नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपेंस, normally if we see when are this banks deposits their fund with the RBI, this mechanism is basically called reverse repo mechanism. So RBI offers some rate of interest to the bank. RBI जो है वो bank को कुछ interest देता है, ठीक है? तो कॉन्सेप्ट पढ़ाने में मजा आता है. फैक्चुअल चीजों में मैं भी परेशान हो जाता हूँ, लेकिन पढ़ानी हो पड़ती है ना? तो जो मैं मॉर्निंग से पढ़ा रहा हूँ वो मैक्सिमम चीजें फैक्चुअल थी, उसमें मजा नहीं आता. ये जो कॉन्सेप्चुअल चीजें होती है ना, इसमें बड़ा मजा आता है. चलिए तो समझते हैं. आरबीआई रिसीव्स द मनी फ्रॉम द बैंक एंड गिव द इंटरेस्ट, राइट? गिव्स द इंटरेस्ट. सो दिस इज द ट्रांजेक्शन विच हैपन्स नॉर्मली. But many a times, so basically, let us see this transaction only first. So in this case, what is happening? Suppose the public also wants a loan, but there is a crisis in the market. In the market, all the businesses are falling. सारे business डूब रहे हैं. सारे business डूब रहे हैं. ठीक है ना? Nothing is going good in the economy. For example, even this corona time pe bhi sab kuch bhi acha nahi ho raha hai. So banks will not be interested in giving loan to the public. So if bank have some extra money, they have two choices. Either they can give money to the public, ya to public ko paisa de sakte hain, or they can deposit the money with the RBI through reverse repo. So if there is a crisis in the market, they will not be interested to give loan to the public. They will keep this money with the RBI and will be interested in taking the loan from the RBI. So this is what happens normally. But if this happens, agar aisa hota hai, the public will not get any loan. The economy will fall. The economy will crash. Because on the one hand, already there is a crisis, and on the other hand, the banks are not ready to give the loan. So the economy will crash, businesses will crash, everything will be crashed, which will be very, very dangerous for the economy. So in the exceptional cases, for example, during the 2008 financial crisis in the USA, this kind of mechanism was introduced for the first time. So what happened? The USA Central Bank, that is the Federal Bank, it introduced negative rate policy. USA Federal Bank said that if you deposit the money with me, agar aap mujhe paisa dete ho, so I will not pay the interest to you. Rather, you will pay the interest to me. Aap mujhe uspe bhi interest doge. ठीक है, क्योंकि मैंने आपका पैसा अपने पास रखा सेफ, राइट? सो द बैंक्स विल बी डिस्करेज्ड टू गिव द मनी टू द सेंट्रल बैंक. दे विल बी इंटरेस्टेड इन गिविंग लोन टू द पब्लिक, बिकॉज इफ दे गिव टू द सेंट्रल बैंक दे हैव टू पे द इंटरेस्ट. इफ दे गिव द मनी टू द पब्लिक एटलीस्ट दे विल गेट समथिंग फ्रॉम द पब्लिक, राइट? सो इन द टाइम ऑफ क्राइसिस दिस नेगेटिव रेट पॉलिसी इज यूज्ड बाय द सेंट्रल बैंक्स. दिस इज वेरी अनकन्वेंशनल टूल एंड इन द रिसेंट ईयर्स, इन द रिसेंट कपल ऑफ ईयर्स दिस मैकेनिज्म इज ऑल्सो बींग फॉलोड बाय सम अदर कंट्रीज. ठीक है, सो एनआरपी वॉज कंसिडर्ड ओनली फॉर इकोनॉमीज विद क्रॉनिकली लो इन्फ्लेशन. जहां पर लो इन्फ्लेशन होता है, इकोनॉमी इज नॉट डूइंग गुड, इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ इज नेगेटिव, देर इज रिसेशन. ठीक है, तो क्राइसिस है सब जगह, सच एज यूरोप एंड जापान. नाउ इट इज बिकमिंग वेरी नॉर्मल फॉर देम ऑल्सो, राइट? व्हाई इट इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड? टू बैटल द ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस, स्पेशली आफ्टर द 2008 क्राइसिस. नाउ ऑल्सो ए डेकेड लेटर, सो आफ्टर 2008, इन 2018, दैट इज नाउ ए डेज, इन द लास्ट कपल ऑफ ईयर्स, द ग्लोबल इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी लेस. सो एट दिस टाइम द रूम टू कट फर्दर रेट इज नॉट देयर. जो सेंट्रल बैंक है उन्होंने ऑलरेडी रेपो रेट कम करते चले गए. दे आर ऑलरेडी रिड्यूसिंग द रेपो रेट टू गिव मनी टू द पब्लिक, कि रेपो रेट कम करो, चीप लोन दो, रेपो रेट कम करो, चीप लोन दो. बट ऑल दैट हैज बीन डन. नाउ दे हैव नो अदर चॉइस बट दे हैव टू गो फॉर द नेगेटिव रेट पॉलिसी. द यूरो एरिया, स्विट्जरलैंड, डेनमार्क, स्वीडन, जापान, दे आर नाउ डूइंग ऑल दिस. ठीक है, तो पहले सिर्फ यूएसए ने किया था, अभी ये सब कंट्रीज कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, सो हाउ डज इट वर्क? अंडर द नेगेटिव रेट पॉलिसी द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर रिक्वायर्ड टू पे द इंटरेस्ट फॉर पार्किंग द एक्सेस रिजर्व विद द सेंट्रल बैंक. सो इफ दे आर डिपॉजिटिंग द मनी विद द सेंट्रल बैंक विल नॉट पे द इंटरेस्ट, रादर दे हैव टू पे द इंटरेस्ट टू द सेंट्रल बैंक. द सेंट्रल बैंक पेनलाइजेस the financial institutions for holding on to cash in hope of prompting them to boost lending. So what are the benefits? It will lower down the borrowing cost for the general public, right? It will help weaken the country's currency, hai na? To kya hota hai ki when there is such kind of situation, the availability of the domestic currency gets reduced. Jo domestic currency hoti hai उसका वॉल्यूम कम हो जाता है, बिकॉज द बैंक्स आर नॉट रेडी टू लैंड. व्हेन बैंक्स आर नॉट रेडी टू लैंड देन द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द मनी सप्लाई इज रिड्यूस्ड, डोमेस्टिक करेंसी का वॉल्यूम कम हो जाता है. व्हेन समथिंग इज लेस इन वॉल्यूम, दैट इज द सप्लाई इज लेस, इफ द सप्लाई ऑफ समथिंग इज लेस द एक्सटर्नल वैल्यू और द प्राइस ऑफ दैट इंक्रीजेस. सो the external value of the domestic currency increases, that means the domestic currency appreciates. The domestic currency wo appreciate karti hai. Appreciating domestic currency is not good for the export. Theek hai, so we will discuss this concept in detail in the chapter of external sector. Jab hum external sector ko padhenge us samay hum isko detail mein samjhenge. But just understand that when there is short supply of money in the market, it appreciates the value of domestic currency, which is not good for the export, right? Which is not good for the export, because our export become expensive in the economy. Hamare jo export hote hain wo expensive ban jate hain. This negative rate policy is able to counter this appreciation in the domestic currency price. Because of the negative rate policy, the money supply is increased. When money supply is increased, the supply of domestic currency increases and the external value of the domestic currency comes down. So the our exports also become competitive. Hamare jo export hote hain wo bhi competitive ban jate hain. So this is another advantage of the negative rate policy. But what are the issues? The issues are that it actually hurts the entire yield curve. हम डिस्कस करेंगे व्हाट इज द यील्ड कर्व इन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. इट डिस्टर्ब्स द मार्जिन ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस. उनको तो उनका जो रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट होता है वो बहुत कम हो जाता है, उनके जो मार्जिन होते हैं वो हर्ट होते हैं. इट हर्ट्स द हेल्थ ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, राइट. सो यू कैन सी द आंसर. आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, ओनली वन, राइट. एनी डाउट टिल नाउ? किसी को कोई डाउट है? चलिए ग्रेट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज द यील्ड कर्व. ठीक है, तो प्लीज गिव द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन, देन वी विल डिस्कस इन्वर्टेड यील्ड कर्व. So I have got only one correct answer. It means each one of you need to understand this concept very very carefully. सिर्फ अभी तक एक आंसर ठीक मिला है मुझे. श्रेया has given the right answer. राहुल has also given the right answer. Only two people has given the right answer. श्रेया एंड राहुल. शुभजीत ने भी सही आंसर दिया है. या शुभजीत ऑल्सो गिवन द राइट आंसर. गुड, वेरी गुड. साहित्या, नो 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 नो, अभी भी आपका आंसर ठीक नहीं है. कोई बात नहीं, डोंट वरी. बहुत ही अच्छा क्वेश्चन है. ओके, सो आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी. आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी. गुड, वेल डन. चलिए तो डिस्कस करते हैं. सो दिस इज इन्वर्टेड यील्ड कर्व. इसको इन्वर्टेड यील्ड कर्व बोलते हैं. सो नॉर्मली क्या होता है, नॉर्मली क्या होता है, नॉर्मली इफ यू आर जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड, डोंट रीड फ्रॉम द स्लाइड. अभी कुछ पढ़ो मत ना, अभी समझो सिर्फ जो मैं बोल रहा हूं. ठीक है, जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड. नॉर्मली यू आर इन्वेस्टर, यू हैव टू चॉइसेस, इन्वेस्ट इन द वन ईयर बॉन्ड एंड इन्वेस्ट इन द टू ईयर बॉन्ड, राइट. रादर यू से 20 ईयर बॉन्ड. ठीक है, दिस वन ईयर बॉन्ड इज ऑफरिंग 5% रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. 20 ईयर बॉन्ड इज ऑल्सो ऑफरिंग 5% रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. विच बॉन्ड यू विल प्रिफर, विच बॉन्ड यू विल प्रिफर, प्लीज गिव, प्लीज टेल मी इन द चैट बॉक्स.
अगर दोनों ही सेम रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ऑफर कर रहे हों तो कौन सा बॉन्ड आप प्रीफर करोगे? सो फॉर द सेक ऑफ सेविंग द टाइम लेट मी गिव द आंसर. ए नॉर्मल इन्वेस्टर विल ऑलवेज प्रीफर द शॉर्ट टर्म इन्वेस्टमेंट. क्यों? इफ यू सी दिस वन ईयर बॉन्ड इट हैज लेस रिस्क, इसमें कम रिस्क है भाई. दिस 20 ईयर बॉन्ड इज हैविंग मोर रिस्क. व्हाट विल हैपन आफ्टर द 20 ईयर इफ आई एम इन्वेस्टिंग 1 lakh rupees, वेदर आई विल बी एबल टू गेट बैक 1 lakh rupees. कोरोना की तरह कोई दूसरा वायरस आ गया तो क्या होगा? ठीक है, डिजास्टर आ गया तो क्या होगा? सो देर इज अ हाई रिस्क आफ्टर 20 ईयर. वी डोंट नो व्हाट विल हैपन टेक्नोलॉजिकली, यू नो वेदर वी विल बी अलाइव और नॉट. तो 20 ईयर इज अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम, रिस्क इज हाई. सो आई विल एक्सपेक्ट मोर इंटरेस्ट ऑन द लॉन्ग टर्म लोन. आर यू गेटिंग? जो लॉन्ग टर्म इन्वेस्टमेंट होगा मैं चाहूंगा कि उस पर ज्यादा मुझे इंटरेस्ट मिले. आर यू गेटिंग? प्लीज से यस. नॉर्मली भी अगर हम देखते हैं, इवन इफ वी गो टू द बैंक एंड वी मेक सम FD, फिक्स डिपॉजिट हम जब करते हैं तब भी तो ऐसी होता है. वेन वी गो टू द बैंक, बैंक पेज हाई रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ऑन द लॉन्ग टर्म FD. अगर आप FD 5 साल के लिए 10 साल के लिए करोगे तो रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ज्यादा होता है उस पे. एग्रीड ऑन नॉट? सो दिस इज अ नॉर्मल यील्ड कर्व. ये नॉर्मल यील्ड कर्व होता है. ठीक है, सो सपोज दिस इज अ 3 month bond, that is a short term, and this is a long term. ये long term हो गया. ठीक है, so the short term is having less and long term is having high. This is a normal yield curve. ये normal yield curve है. ठीक है मनीष, यू आर सेइंग बट सर लॉन्ग टर्म लोन बार बार इन्वेस्ट करने का टेंशन भी तो होता है, एक बार इन्वेस्ट करके भूल जाओ. मेरे दोस्त, जब आपके पास पैसा होगा ना तब आपको पता चलेगा. अभी बहुत आसान है कहना, है ना. इन्वेस्ट करके भूल जाओ मतलब पैसा मिलेगा नहीं मिलेगा उसकी चिंता नहीं है आपको, आपको सिर्फ इंटरेस्ट चाहिए. ऐसा नहीं होता मेरे दोस्त, बी प्रैक्टिकल. जब जेब से अपनी पैसा दोगे ना तब देखोगे, तब बोलोगे भाई मुझे सिर्फ 1 साल के लिए लगा दो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, लेकिन मेरा पैसा वापस मिल जाए ऐसी जगह लगाऊंगा पैसा मैं. 20 साल बाद मैं मुझे पैसा नहीं मिले तो क्या फायदा होगा? आर यू गेटिंग? तो प्रैक्टिकल सोचो. अभी तो पेरेंट्स का पैसा है ना. सो चलिए, बट इन केस ऑफ इन्वर्टेड यील्ड कर्व, इन्वर्टेड यील्ड कर्व में क्या होता है, दिस short term rate of interest it becomes higher than the long term rate of interest. Can you see here? So this is the inverted yield curve. Isko inverted yield curve bolte hain. Theek hai? So why does that happen? Wo kyun hota hai? So it happens because when there is a short term crisis going to happen, agar short term mein koi crisis hone wala hai, if people are expecting that in the short term there will be no if I invest for the short term then there are chances of loss, because in the short term the crisis is happening. Short term mein sirf crisis ho raha hai. Theek hai, short term mein crisis hone wala hai, there is no trust over the short term performance of the bond. So at the time most of the people they will try to buy the long term security buy karne ki koshish karenge ki bhai short term ko to pata nahi hai kya hone wala hai agle 6 mahine mein 3 mahine mein 1 saal mein hum isme long term mein paisa invest karenge. So at that time this yield curve becomes inverted, right? So it occurs when interest rate on the short term bond are higher than the interest rate paid by the long term bond. So jab if everyone start investing on the long term, then the person who is receiving this money, the person will offer less rate of interest. Wo less rate of interest offer karenge. The people are ready to invest even on the less rate of interest, because they are very much disappointed with the upcoming economic recession in the next few months or maybe for next couple of years, right? So it means people are so worried about the near-term future that they are piling into the safer long-term investment. Jo safe investment hote hain, for example, investment into the government security. So that is a safe investment. They will not invest into the short-term security, which is having very low probability of giving the return, right? It is a predictor of the economic recession, right? So in the USA, in the recent days, a 10-year bond rate has fallen in the point at which the 10-year rate is below the 2-year rate. So the yield curve is inverted. So aisa USA ke andar hua hai. USA mein aisa hua hai. Theek hai? So it is the predictor of the economic recession. It is the predictor of the economic recession. Now if you see the answer, so the answer is option C. Yahan par option C answer hota hai. First statement is right. Second statement is also right. Third statement is also right. Take 5 seconds and read this again if you are confused. Theek hai? Chaliye, now the time for the homework. Homework ka time ho gaya hai. Are you ready for the homework?